KCRA 3 News begins with a breaking news first alert.
Breaking out live right now, a hazardous materials fire in Sacramento has reignited this evening, sending thick black plumes of toxic smoke billowing into the sky. Live Copter 3 HD above the scene right now on Elder Creek Road. It looks like firefighters are starting to get that fire under control as they start to put water on top of that truck there that had all the material in it.
Good evening. I'm Edie Lambert along with Gulston Dart. KCRA 3's Mike DeSell joining us live from the scene where firefighters now look like they're getting control of that fire, but Mike, for a second time today.
Yeah, and in fact, let me take you there right now. Look alive across Elder Creek. You can see the fire officials still throwing some water on this trailer fire. This is the second time today that really they've been responding to an incident out here. Let me take you to some video we shot earlier. Take a look at this. And this is a look at when this thing reignited. You can see from Live Copter 3 HD clearly how intense this fire was. And what this started with this morning was a concern of smoke coming from the trailer here. It was just white smoke at that point in time. It was a level 3 hazmat response. Sacramento Fire Department came out here. They quickly determined after looking at the manifest that there was a whole slew of chemicals inside this trailer that was of concern. Fortunately, by about 2 or 3 o'clock this afternoon, they had thought that they pretty much had this situation stabilized. It was just about an hour ago that things reignited in here. And joining me now is Captain Davis from the Sacramento Fire Department. At this point, any idea why this reignited?
At this point, we still haven't completed the investigation to determine exactly what started the fire. As you said earlier, we're out here for the hazardous materials release that happened from this trailer. There were some fumes coming out. We could have possibly had some kind of a mixing of the chemicals in there. But we did keep fire suppression units on scene, along with the hazardous materials unit, to assist in the private contractor coming in to help start cleaning up this incident from earlier.
And that private contractor, Clean Harbors of West Sac, they hadn't actually arrived yet, correct?
I'm not sure. I wasn't here for that portion of it, but they were here. Our suppression companies were here as a precautionary measure in case something like this did happen. This is always a possibility when you're dealing with multiple chemicals like this. So we kept resources here on scene to be here to mitigate any type of a fire incident. Somehow or another, that trailer did start on fire, and we started an aggressive attack right away on it. We did keep all the adjoining trailers, which also have some hazardous materials in them, from catching on fire. So we pretty much, as far as I can tell right now, or from the information I have, is contained to that one trailer right now.
And real quick, as far as the chemicals inside, I understand from earlier when we were talking with you guys that there was a concern that you don't know what's going to happen when those chemicals start to mix or leak with any type of rupture in there. Is it possible this was some sort of chemical reaction, and how many chemicals are in that truck?
Yeah, like I said, it's possible that's what could have happened. We don't know, and we'll try to find that out in the investigation. But with multiple unknown chemicals being stored in there, when and if they do mix, you can have a reaction that produces heat, and thus you end up with a fire eventually. So that is one possibility, but like I said, we're not sure exactly yet what happened. But we do have suppression resources here. We've got more en route, and so we do have ongoing suppression efforts to keep it contained to that one trailer.
And Captain Roland Davis, thank you very much. Yep. And again, take a look here. You can see a much different scene than what you saw from Live Copter 3 HD. They are starting to get a significant handle on this. What is going to happen once they do get this stabilized? They'll hand it over to County OES, who will take over. But again, just to reiterate, if you weren't watching this earlier, some 40 different hazardous materials inside that one trailer. So clearly, they're going to look into whether or not some chemical mixture had something to do with this. Live along Elder Creek Road, which is shut down at this moment. Mike DeSell, KCRA 3 reports.
Yeah, and Mike, as we look at your live picture, we're going to go to a map real quick just to kind of orient people to show exactly where we're talking about here in South Sacramento, a couple of miles south of Interstate, or I should say Highway 50 there. It's at Elder Creek and also Florin Perkins Road. So there's the map, and you can see this is where we're talking about here. And it's been burning pretty good, and now it's good to see that the black smoke's gone.
One of the reasons that we want to show you this map and really look at these neighborhoods is because the fire department had issued an order to shelter in place for certain communities. Mark has been watching the wind patterns in that area.
Yeah, and the wind has been steady out of the west and southwest in that area at around 8 to 10 miles an hour. And with the fire itself around Elder Creek and Florin Perkins Road, that would mean any communities around Bradshaw, South Watt, Jackson Highway, maybe as far east as Mather Field, but that far away, which is only a few miles, but that far away, the smoke would begin to disperse quite a bit. But if you're even in one of those neighborhoods around Mather Field, you may also want to just stay inside until all of the smoke does dissipate. But again, you notice that from the pictures we've been showing you, that the smoke is not as thick as it was a couple of hours ago, or even just a half an hour ago. But if the closer you are to that and the thicker the smoke is, that's where the real hazard is. But any of those areas that are downwind of that fire, with that wind out of the south and southwest, those are the communities that they're talking about sheltering in place. Back to you.
And Mark, we should point out that when this fire first broke out this morning, three people were sent to the hospital with inhalation issues from those toxics. So again, if you're in those communities, we can't stress strongly enough, you do not want to breathe this stuff in.
Yeah, plenty of reason for concern there.